Mark CC back in for the video. That's MAWKCC. Look me up on pretty much anything. I got Switch, Wii U, PS3, PS4, Xbox One, Skype, Discord, Snapchat, Instagram. Facebook, Yahoo, Google, GOG, Steam, obviously YouTube. Back in here playing some more Darksiders, Warmaster Edition, you know. Also on Xbox One, Steam, PS3, and 360, and also the Wii U, and I believe it's also on GOG. Not sure about that, but you know. The PS3 and the PS4 versions don't have the PS3 and 360 versions. You know, the original ones from 2010 don't have this, the 1080p upscaling. They're 720, but I mean, they're only like a couple bucks nowadays, you know what I'm saying? You get those for like a couple bucks. I got this for a couple bucks too, but I mean, you know, if you don't care, you know, it's the same game. I mean, and they're a lot better than, you know, some people would give these games. These games are really good. You know, if you're a fan of the hack and slash genre, you love PC, go ahead and pick it up. But you get a big sword, and you know, this game is kind of like Dante's Inferno meets God of War meets Hellboy. You know what I mean? It's 3D hack and slash team up. But it takes ideas from God of War. It takes ideas from Dante's Inferno. It takes ideas from Zelda. It takes ideas from just platforming and 3D, you know, adventure games and action games and, you know, hack and slash and all that. And the story is actually depicted from Revelations, actually, you know, a little bit of Revelations in the Bible, you know, so, you know, that's like the myth, like, I wouldn't say mythology because the Bible is not fake, but, you know, that's where the ideology comes from, I guess, or the story comes from, I guess, you know, it's not exactly like Revelations, but it's like, you know, that's where the, like, initial idea of the story comes from, because in this one you're playing as War, and two you're playing as Death. Like, if they're two of the four horsemen of the apocalypse, which is, you know, directly from Revelation. is not active 100% with the horseman concept. That's the basic concept. That's a little backstory of it. Well, we're known. This game would be good to play multiple times because, you know, it's long enough to where you play once and you're satisfied, so I don't know. The character in, I'll give you one thing, the character in Death in Darksiders 2 looks cooler than this guy. Trophies are both, you know, achievements are both versions, the 360 versions, you know, Xbox One versions. It kind of has like this GTA, you know, GTA Infamous type of map, but also it's kind of like, you know, I don't know, kind of like Legacy of Kain, you know, where you're walking around, you know, like that. Kind of reminds me a little bit of that. If you like Legacy of Kain, you'll probably like these Darksiders games. Although Legacy of Kain is way better than these Darksiders games. Just, you know. Well, at least Soul Reaver 2 are way better than this, but, you know. They're very similar, they're just primitive versions of like games like this, you know. But, this has that old school, you know, early open world style, you know, before open world became like way too open worldy. This is like a good balance between, you know, closed world games and open world games. Well, in my opinion, at least.
Non struga sindura. Do you know what's imprisoned here? There are things even you should fear, horseman. Once you were strong, but now you are weak and you are alone. The destroyer knows of your coming. Even now, he moves his legions against you.
Then I'll make this quick.
I mean, this has very good Ella.
Drum ein Ghoul Stragador.
Non straga sim.
Damn, man, these graphics are hella dated, dude.
Just one hideous blood-puking gargoyle. The plumbing must be stopped up.
But what's crazy about this is that if this was made before Dante's Inferno, though. So I guess Dante's Inferno took away from this, but I've always looked at Darksiders like a mixture of God of War, Dante's Inferno together. The style is very similar to God of War. It also takes a lot of influence from the Legend of Kain series. You can tell, man, like them kind of games.
War. Are you here to play execution? They should have sent all four of you.
I have no interest in killing you, Samael.
Ah, the Destroyer! He's beyond your reach, beyond mine.
Has prison made you a coward?
Perhaps there is a way, but you will need to get inside the Destroyer's spire. The tower is guarded by four of his chosen. Bring me their hearts and ask me no questions. My reasons for helping you are my own.
Where can I find these guardians?
First, seek the Twilight Cathedral, where the Bat Queen Tiamat has gone to roost. The whole of her domain is a blistered inferno. By land, you will never reach it. Find the high ground with this. And bring me her still beating heart.
Got the wings. Hell yeah. That's like something straight out of Legacy. Like, oh yeah, man. Shh. Oh, no trophy. I just got two trophies. I'm freeing that guy and getting the ability to use the wings. Hell yeah. These games are really good, actually. I don't know, they are underrated because they're way more fun than like a lot of these stupid open world games. Like I play this over a Fallout or Assassin's Creed or you know, or Madden or you know, or something, or Call of Duty any damn day. This and like God of War, you know? Alright, the last God of War game I came out is pretty good too. Well, I prefer more of a God of War to me, you know. I still got those games to play. You know? I like it, you know, but I don't know. I didn't like God of War, the new one, as much as everyone else did, but it is still an amazing game. Like it is a great game, but I don't know. Maybe I have to play it longer, but the beginning of it just I don't know, it's kind of a boring beginning. Damn. that dead? This? The wall? Damn! The wall here looks like something out of The Haunting. It really does. Dude, I would love to have a game like that again, dude. Those are the best, man. War of Death, I'm thumping on Raziel. He was mad cool. That's hard. That part right there is hard. Yeah, that part is hard.
Thank you.
come for the Destroyer.
My brother spoke of your coming. But a powerful curse holds me now. I cannot help you.
Any curse can be broken.
Yes, perhaps. These servants of the Destroyer walk unseen within the realm of shadow. By their blood we are bound. By their blood shall we be free.
I can no longer move within the shadow realm. Much of my power has left me.
You need not enter it. I will grant you the power to see into the accursed realm for a time. But to what end? What hope have we now against the Destroyer's foul sorcery?
Hope will not bring you freedom.
This also shows a little bit of like more coming conquest on it. That is a really, that's really good. I really like those. No, I have that.
No challenge.
something new is going on, dude. This kind of feels like something.
Yeah.
Doesn't look like PS2 graphics. But you can definitely see that it's PS3. Darksiders is good, but, you know, hopefully 3 will be way better, but at least for the first one, you know, at least at the beginning of it, you know, you want to get this game for as cheap as you can, you know, play anyway you want, any way you can, you know, but like cheap, you know. The series itself is good, but it's no Ninja Gaiden. It's no God of War 3, but I don't know. They are underrated, I'll tell you that. I mean, I got this for $1.99. So, yeah, hell yeah.